Hello everyone, I hope you are doing well. Here is your chemistry teacher and now in this video, we are going to start with the third chapter, water. As we all know that water is one of the most common and most essential substance on earth because nearly 71% of the earth's surface is covered with water and without water, life is not even possible. Water occurs in free state as well as in combined state. In free state, it occurs in solid, liquid, and gaseous state. You can easily see these three states of water around you. In solid state, it is found in the form of ice, snow, glaciers, etc. In liquid state, it is found in rivers, lakes, soil, well, sea, etc. And the gaseous state of water occurs as water vapor, clouds, fog, etc. Water occurs in all living things, that is plants and animals, in the combined state. You know, 70% of our body weight is water only. In combined state, it is also present in hydrated salts such as copper sulfate crystals, magnesium chloride crystals, and washing soda, etc. Today we know that water is a compound. But you know, earlier it was believed that water is an element. For the very first time in 1781, the scientist Henry Cavendish proved that we can prepare water by igniting 2 volumes of hydrogen and 1 volume of oxygen. Means, if we take a mixture of oxygen and hydrogen in a container such that the amount of hydrogen is double the amount of oxygen and ignite this mixture, then we get water as a result of reaction between hydrogen and oxygen. After that, in 1783, the scientist Lavoisier proved that water is a compound made of hydrogen and oxygen atoms combined together in ratio 2:1. Everyone knows that water occurs naturally in rain, rivers, sea, etc. But do we drink this water? No. We drink filtered water, which is obtained by treating the naturally occurring water. The water which occurs in nature in free state is called natural water, and the water which is obtained by treating natural water by man-made processes is called treated water. For example, water obtained by distillation of natural water is called distilled water. The distilled water is the purest form of water as it does not contain any dissolved gases or salts. But this water is not used for drinking purpose because it does not contain the salts or minerals which are required for the proper growth of our body. And the water used for drinking is called potable water. We obtain potable water from natural water by treating it with alum and then passing through filters and afterwards disinfecting it by passing chlorine gas through it. Water is a compound and it is called so because it shows all the characteristics of a compound. Let's have a look on these characteristics. Number 1. As compound is a substance made up of 2 or more different kinds of elements combined together in a fixed ratio by mass. And water is also made up of hydrogen and oxygen. Both are the different elements and these are combined together in fixed ratio, that is 1:8 by mass. So we can say that water is a compound. Secondly, the compounds can be produced by reacting its constituent elements together. Also, water is produced from hydrogen and oxygen as a result of a chemical reaction. And like all compounds, the properties of water are also different from its constituent elements because hydrogen burns itself and oxygen is a supporter of combustion, but water can extinguish fire. Also, like other compounds, the components of water cannot be separated by physical methods. These can only be separated by chemical methods, or we can use electrolysis of water for separating hydrogen and oxygen from water. And like other compounds, water also has its fixed freezing point as well as fixed boiling point. The freezing point of water is 0 degrees Celsius and the boiling point of water is 100 degrees Celsius. In the formation of compounds, energy is either evolved or it is absorbed. And in case of the formation of water from hydrogen and oxygen, energy is released. So all these properties of water make it a compound. It is also important to know that water is called a universal solvent because it can dissolve a large number of solutes than any other solvent. But do you know what factors make it a universal solvent? Factor number 1 is that water is polar in nature. Now you may wonder, what is polar nature? For this, let's have a brief look on the structure of water. One water molecule is made up of 2 atoms of hydrogen and 1 atom of oxygen. and in one oxygen atom in the outermost shell, total number of 6 electrons are present. Why 6? Because atomic number of oxygen is 8 and its electronic configuration will be 2, 6. So in the last shell of oxygen, 6 electrons are there. So if we have to represent the Lewis symbol of oxygen, it can be represented as O. And how many electrons we are having in the last shell? These are 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 electrons are there. Hydrogen has 1 electron in the last shell as the atomic number of hydrogen is 1. So its electronic configuration is 1. And we can represent hydrogen as H with 1 dot. Now to acquire the nearest noble gas configuration, oxygen needs 2 more electrons and hydrogen needs 1 more electron. But as both hydrogen and oxygen are non-metals, तो दोनों में से कोई भी एटम इलेक्ट्रॉन लूज नहीं कर सकता. Both have the tendency to gain the electrons. So अगर दो हाइड्रोजन एटम्स एक ऑक्सीजन एटम के साथ अपना अपना एक इलेक्ट्रॉन शेयर कर लें, देन ऑक्सीजन एटम के पास 8 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स कंप्लीट हो सकते हैं, बिकॉज ऑक्सीजन इज ऑलरेडी हैविंग 6 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इन द आउटरमोस्ट शेल. और अगर दो हाइड्रोजन एटम ने अपना अपना एक इलेक्ट्रॉन शेयर कर लिया, देन ऑक्सीजन के पास कितने एटम इलेक्ट्रॉन्स हो जाएंगे? 8. अब जितने इलेक्ट्रॉन्स एक हाइड्रोजन एटम एक ऑक्सीजन एटम के साथ शेयर करेगा, उतने ही इलेक्ट्रॉन्स एक ऑक्सीजन एटम भी उस हाइड्रोजन के साथ शेयर करेगा. हियर वन हाइड्रोजन हैज शेयर्ड इट्स वन इलेक्ट्रॉन विद द ऑक्सीजन, सो ऑक्सीजन विल ऑल्सो शेयर वन इलेक्ट्रॉन विद द हाइड्रोजन. सेम इज द केस विद द सेकेंड हाइड्रोजन. सो नाउ सी हियर, हाइड्रोजन के पास कितने इलेक्ट्रॉन्स हो गए? हाइड्रोजन is now having 2 electrons. Like this, both hydrogen and oxygen atom can acquire their nearest noble gas configuration. And this type of bond between two atoms by equal and mutual sharing of electrons between them is called a covalent bond. So we can say that in water, oxygen and hydrogen are combined through covalent bond. Here you must know the meaning of one more term, that is electronegativity. Electronegativity means the tendency of an atom to attract the shared pair of electrons towards itself. Shared pair of electrons means the pair of electrons which are shared between two atoms for the formation of a chemical bond or a covalent bond. Now here, in the molecule of water, as oxygen is more electronegative than hydrogen, therefore the shared pair of electrons between the oxygen and hydrogen atoms are shifted more towards oxygen atom. Means hydrogen se wo electron dur honge, oxygen ke thoda pass honge. Now hydrogen's own electron is somewhat far from it. मीन्स कि हाइड्रोजन ने इलेक्ट्रॉन को पूरा लूज नहीं किया, बट उसने अपना इलेक्ट्रॉन मीन्स कि अपना नेगेटिव चार्ज अपने से थोड़ा दूर कर दिया, जिसकी वजह से उस पे क्या आ जाएगा? स्मॉल पॉजिटिव चार्ज. दिस डेल्टा डिनोट्स द स्मॉल पॉजिटिव चार्ज, मीन्स पार्शियल पॉजिटिव चार्ज. और अगर इसका इलेक्ट्रॉन हाइड्रोजन का इलेक्ट्रॉन दूर हुआ, देन वो किसके पास है? ऑक्सीजन के पास. मींस ऑक्सीजन के पास किसी और एटम का नेगेटिव चार्ज आ गया, पूरा का पूरा गेन नहीं किया लेकिन थोड़ा सा तो उसके पास है, देन दैट्स व्हाई उस पे भी क्या आ जाएगा? स्मॉल नेगेटिव चार्ज. सेम इज द केस विद द सेकेंड हाइड्रोजन एटम. दिस हाइड्रोजन एटम्स इलेक्ट्रॉन इज ऑल्सो फार फ्रॉम इट, सो इट विल ऑल्सो अक्वायर अ पॉजिटिव चार्ज ऑन इट, एंड ड्यू टू दिस this oxygen atom also acquires a small negative charge. Now here, oxygen atom carries a small negative charge and hydrogen atoms carry small positive charge. Why? Due to the difference in electronegativities of oxygen and hydrogen. So due to the difference in the electronegativities of hydrogen and oxygen, two charged poles are generated in water molecule, and this kind of compounds are called polar compounds. So we can say that water is a polar compound. And due to the polar nature, means due to the presence of positive and negative charge on the water molecule, it can attract the negative and positive charge respectively of the molecules of solute which are put into water, and thus the molecules of solute dissolve in water. The second factor which makes water a universal solvent is that water can form hydrogen bonds with the molecules of other compounds. So what is a hydrogen bond? Hydrogen bond is the attraction between the hydrogen atom covalently bonded to very electronegative atom like nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine and another very electronegative atom. For example, in case of water, hydrogen is covalently bonded to very electronegative element, that is oxygen. So the hydrogen present in water can form attraction with other molecules in which the elements like nitrogen and oxygen or fluorine are present. Means अगर हम कोई ऐसा इसमें कोई भी compound mix करेंगे जिसमें कोई बहुत ही ज्यादा electronegative element present हो, जैसे कि nitrogen, oxygen और fluorine है, तो hydrogen उसके साथ attraction produce करेगा, उसके साथ attract होना शुरू हो जाएगा. अगर hydrogen उसे attract करेगा, it means वो चीज उसमें डिजॉल्व हो जाएगी, मीन्स के वॉटर में डिजॉल्व हो जाएगी. सो इट ऑल्सो मेक्स वॉटर अ यूनिवर्सल सॉल्वेंट. द थर्ड फैक्टर इज दैट वॉटर मॉलिक्यूल हैज अ हाई डाई इलेक्ट्रिक कॉन्स्टेंट. नाउ लेट अस सी व्हाट इज डाई इलेक्ट्रिक कॉन्स्टेंट. हियर वी कैन सिंपली डिफाइन डाई इलेक्ट्रिक कॉन्स्टेंट एज अ प्रॉपर्टी विच रिड्यूसेज द फोर्सेज ऑफ अट्रैक्शन बिटवीन द एग्जिस्टिंग एटम्स. लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड इट विद वन एग्जाम्पल. You must remember the formation of sodium chloride molecule. So how is it formed? One sodium atom loses one electron to form sodium positive ion, and the electron which is lost by sodium is gained by chlorine atom to form chloride ion. And due to the presence of opposite charges on sodium and chloride ions, they attract each other to form a compound. It means in sodium chloride, sodium atom carries positive charge and chlorine atom carries negative charge. When this sodium chloride is dissolved in water, the sodium and chloride ions and the polar water molecules attract one another because of the presence of opposite charges on them. The water molecules attract ions to such an extent that the force of attraction between sodium and chloride ions weakens and they are pulled far apart from each other. Then the positively charged sodium ions will be surrounded by the negative charge of water molecules and the negatively charged chloride ions will be surrounded by the positive charge of water molecules. Due to this, Na positive and Cl negative will not be able to combine and will not crystallize and remain dissolved in water. Like this, water separates the ionic and polar covalent compounds by weakening their existing bonds. And that's why we say that the dielectric constant of water is high. The next factor is that water molecules can enter in chemical reaction with other compounds. For example, as we did in the previous chapter, that in double decomposition reactions, the aqueous solutions of compounds react with one another. Also, water can enter in chemical reaction with carbon dioxide, with sulfur dioxide, and many other examples are there. So, this was all about what makes water a universal solvent. Then we know that a large amount of water is used daily, but it never gets finished from Earth because of the water cycle. So, what is water cycle? It is the circulation of water from Earth's surface to atmosphere and back to Earth. The water present on Earth gets evaporated by gaining heat energy and form water vapor. Also, the leaves of plants lose water by the process of transpiration. These water vapor, being lighter, goes into the upper atmosphere where they get condensed to form clouds because of less temperature over there. And after that, they get precipitated and fall on Earth in the form of rain, hail, snow, etc. And the water again come back to the Earth. This cycle is continuously going on and thus maintaining the amount of water on Earth.